Kaya pala todo ang kanilang pagsusubikap na ma-impeach si Vice President Sara. Dahil nga isang threat itong si VP Sara na kapag na-impeach si BBM ay ang papalit ay walang iba kundi ang Vice Presidente. Ito ang pagbubulgar ng isang certified DDS na si Tio Moreno. Hindi lang kasi ito usapin ng Marcos versus Duterte dahil nakaabang ang mga kakamping at Dilawan. Kaya habang maaga pa lang ay tatanggalin na nila si VP Sara dahil ganoon na lamang kadaling tanggalin si BBM sa pagkapresidente. Dahil nga marami na itong nagawang violations sa kanyang administrasyon, mabilis na lamang tanggalin si BBM dahil hindi pa nila ito ginagawa. Once kasi na mapatalsik nila agad si BBM, ay syempre ang papalit ay si VP Sara. Kaya ang uunahin muna nila ay si VP Sara. Kaya't ang mananalo sa laban na ito ay walang iba kundi ang mga kakamping. Para sa buong detalye ng revelasyon na ito, panoorin ang buong video. Heto pa ang komento ni Attorney Darwin Cañete. For some reason, publicly persecuting VP Sara seems to have the opposite effect. Her critics are not changing anyone's minds. The public hearings are just reinforcing confirmation bias. The needle is not moving. As observed in the collisions between cars and trains, if it's a tie, you lose. Wala naman sigurong problema if public officials can afford to buy luxury goods from morally earned income. Hindi pinagbabawal ang batas yan. Mayaman ka kung mayaman. Di bawal maging mayaman sa gobyerno. Pera mong pinaghirapan o minana ay sa iyo. Ang kondisyon lang ng batas ay di mo ginamit ang pagka-opisyal mo. Walang conflict of interest at ideklara mo sa SALN. Because it is so obvious, Sara is the last person to engage in corruption. They know that. But they are still trying their luck with power and money. Unfortunately for them, these hearings are revealing their hypocrisy and corruption. On the brighter side, whatever is happening right now makes us rethink whom we should and should not vote for next year elections. For example, after I saw the quad in House Representatives, I will not vote Dan Fernandez for his gubernatorial ambition in our province. At heto na mga kasuwit ang revelasyon at analysis ng certified DDS sa si Tio Moreno na once ma-impeach si Vice President Sara na ang mga loyalista ay tuwang-tuwa pa. Hindi nila alam na may impeach din si BBM sa kamay ng mga kakamping. Ang ending, talo rin kayong mga loyalista. Kaya't mag-isip-isip kayo. Narito ang full video ng kanyang komento at reaksyon. Panoorin natin.
Now, just in case you guys are wondering why the House of Representatives is so obsessed with VP Sara, like they are exhausting everything, their means and their resources and their power just to investigate VP Sara's budget or to cut her budget or to defund the OVP or to reduce the budget and everything, to file cases against her. That is because the number one reason there, guys, is the constitutionally guaranteed seat of VP Sara that she currently possesses, which is the vice president. Because you know, when you study the constitution, in the line of succession, in terms of the disability of the president or death or whatever demise that the president has experienced, whatever, the next in line would be the vice president. Now, why are they so focused with VP Sara? That is because VP Sara is the threat. Siya lang. Siya yung inuuna, di ba? VP Sara keeps on telling us, the public, that they are cooking an impeachment case against her, which is actually true, okay? There are talks already that there are a number of congressmen or members of the House of Representatives who are doing that, who are starting to do that against VP Sara. Now, ganito kasi yan, they are trying to impeach VP Sara as early as now because it's easier to impeach Bongbong Marcos. if they want to. Now ang ito yung sinasabi so sa ito yung sinasabi ko sa inyo na it's not only a battle between, for example, the Dutertes or the Marcoses, but there are also other powers that are at play. One of the prime examples there, guys, is the existence of the Kakampings, the Liberal Party. As you can see, it's only Risa Hontiveros who is able to be part of the Senate na member ng Liberal Party, if I am not mistaken. So they are trying to regain their power by trying to impeach VP Sara, because if they are successful in impeaching the vice president, it would be easier for them to impeach Bongbong Marcos. That's why they are so silent about the corruption or the glaring incompetence or the mind-blowing greed that this administration is currently showing to us Filipino people. It's because nga may nakahanda na dyan. But the threat is VP Sara. Now, if they first target the president, if yung uunahin nila ay si Bongbong Marcos, wala pa rin sila. The effort would be useless. That is because in the Constitution, next in line is the vice president. Kaya, inuuna ang vice president ngayon. Now, if nakikinig or nanonood kayo ng hearing Senate or the House of Representative House of HOR hearing against VP Sara, even the COA is saying that there is no deficiency found on the confidential fund and the budget of the OVP. It's just that they are trying their very best to paint a picture of VP Sara to be corrupt or to be someone who is misusing the public funds, because that's the first thing that they must do. First, to campaign against VP Sara so that they would be able to get support from the public, from the masses. It's just that VP Sara is so intelligent. On the first hearing, diba, nakita naman natin kung paano niya sinabon yung mga congressman, kung paano niya nilaro yung hearing. And it's not about her trying to evade the responsibility or trying to evade the accountability about the confidential funds and the budget of the OVP. It's just that she has the discretion to do so as the head of the department. Now guys, this is the first thing that you should bear in mind. If you're a public official, you have two duties. First is ministerial duties, and the second one is the discretionary duties. When we talk about the ministerial duties, even if you don't want to do that as vice president maybe or ahead of a certain department, you are obligated so because that's under the law or that's part of your mandate. So that's the ministerial duties. Now, when we talk about discretionary duties or responsibilities, if you're head of the department, you are free to strategize or to handle what is best for your department. Now, VP Sara not answering the politically motivated questions of the House of Representatives is actually a discretionary responsibility of the head of such department. So this is one thing that some of the detractors of VP Sara do not understand, or maybe they are well aware about that. It's just that they disregard that fact because they want to really make VP Sara appear as someone who is evading accountability, which is not actually the main case. During the budget hearing, discretion yan. Pwede nga hindi siya mag-a-attend. Kaya nga yung president hindi nag-a-attend because under the discretionary power or under the discretionary responsibilities or mandate of the president, he or she is, whether he or she wants to be present during the budget hearing. So yan yon.
Ano ang masasabi ninyo mga kasuwit sa revelasyon na ito ng certified DDS na si Tio Moreno? Magawa kaya ng mga loyalista na ma-impeach si VP Sara? At kapag nangyaring ma-impeach si VP Sara, mai-impeach din naman si BBM sa kamay ng mga kamping at dilawan. In the end, talo pa rin ang mga loyalista. Kaya't mag-isip-isip na kayo mga loyalista. huwag gahaman sa kapangyarihan. Ano ang inyong opinion? Huwag nang kalimutang i-share ang video na ito. Mag-iwan ng comment at like.